Hello everyone, welcome to the Computex Cyber World 2021. In this section, I'm going to share with you the security for future automotive ecosystem. My name is Peter Yang and I am the Senior Product Manager of Trend Micro. First, let's talk about what is the case and the risk behind it. CASE is the mobility revolution and it stands for connected, autonomous, share, and electrification. As you can see, there are different kinds of applications and also benefit under each category for the CASE. And what exactly it means in terms of the technology side. Connected, it means different kinds of connectivity technology, for example, the 5G, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth. Autonomous means the double E architecture in the vehicle is changing, ADAS and a supercomputer inside your car, and also the line of codes are increasing. Shared means that the vehicle will talk to different kinds of IoT devices, more and more applications and the cloud service now should work together. And electrification, that also means the battery management system, and also the charging station. However, everything we talk here, to Trend Micro's point of view, we feel there are a lot of risks also increasing here. So, what is the motivation for hacker in this case ecosystem? For example, your personal data, your user data, now being stored in the system of the car. That is something valuable for hacker. In the meantime, the car itself, the goods inside the car, and something invisible, which is the energy that stored in your car, also is something considered something interesting for the criminals. The driving service, for example, car sharing, and also auto driving services, that could be potentially used by criminal group for bad purpose. Finally, the network and processor resource of your car. Consider the car is a huge data center now, and also a supercomputer on four wheels that running on the road. So that means the traditional cyber attacks that happen in your PC, in your server, that also potentially happen in the future vehicles. Now we understand the risk and some motivation of hacker behind CASE. How can we prevent it? There are more and more organizations and even government start to focus on this part. Two most important things that you should know here is the UNECE WP29 is the regulation for automotive cybersecurity. The second one, ISO and SAE 21434, is the new standard that is going to be ready this year. And of course, there are other more like ITU, ENISA, NHTSA, and BSI. Those standard and best practice document, you can find it everywhere. First, the ISO SAE 21434. This is the very first time that ISO and SAE sit down together and jointly develop the standard. It is the layout of the organization, process and the technology requirement throughout the vehicle life cycle in terms of the cybersecurity. Here you can also find a very familiar classic V model in this ISO standard. From concept to the product development, then the cybersecurity validation, then goes to the production and the operation on the road and the decommission of the vehicle. Also, it also lay out the capability the organization need to have. For example, the threat intelligence, vulnerability analysis and management. Also, the production security and the capability to support the vehicle SOC. If you have more interest for the detail of 21434, you can also download the white paper provided by Trend Micro for free. The next one, UNECE WP29. This is the cybersecurity management system and the software update management system requirement, which including the requirement of the manufacturer's CSMS, including the process and the framework. and also is the requirement for the vehicle itself. Here, we try to highlight some critical point in this regulation to help you understand what is it about. So, in order to get the approval, you need to have documentation that to prove you have the management capability for your supplier and vendor and third party. Then you need to perform the TERRA, threat analysis and risk assessment. And you need to make sure you have the in-vehicle intrusion detection and protection system. The DR platform and system must be considered, and also you need to have the security log and the data forensic capability. Everything needs to be documented. Then consider the vehicle itself. In the NS5 of WP29, you can find the minimum requirement to secure or to mitigate the threat for the connected vehicle. And it also covers 7 different categories, including like vehicle itself, backend server, communication and vulnerability, etc. And again, for the vehicle itself, you need to make sure you have the mitigation, you have the solution for in-vehicle IDPS, you have the capability to collect the security log, and then you have capability to monitor the threat and do the data forensic. WP29 is a mandatory for all new vehicle types from July 2022 and all new vehicles that produce from July 2024. Now you already have the idea of the standard and the regulation that is coming. And what is Trend Micro's recommendation to this? Vehicle SOC. Vehicle Security Operations Center is the best solution for requirement and actually to secure your case ecosystem. Now you already designed the car with cybersecurity concept and the mindset. When it goes to the production line, the OT, IIoT security need to be deployed in your smart factory, in your planet. Then, when the car was developed, produced, it goes to the road in the market. The vehicle security should be inside. The car will talk to different devices, the smart IoT devices like your smartphone, smart watch, and your smart house. Then the IoT security should also be deployed in different places for those IoT devices. Your car talks to your backend server, your application server, your data center through different kind of connectivity technology like 5G. So network security considers something also important. And no need to say, your backend IT system must have the traditional IT security in place. However, with so many endpoints and the channel and the environment, how can you manage and make sure everything is under your control? This is the importance of having the vehicle SOC. With vehicle SOC, you are able to monitor each stage, each phase of the car, and also the status of the whole ecosystem. Now you can do the data forensic. Once something bad has happened, you can do the threat hunting, and you can also do the incident response. So the vehicle SOC considered a very critical point in this ecosystem. Next, I'm going to share with you some solution or recommendation based on Trend Micro's experience, how to make the vehicle SOC and the in-vehicle security happen. We want to borrow this map, this picture from AutoSAR. In AutoSAR, there is a proposal talking about how to develop or consider the in-vehicle onboard IDS system and also the vehicle SOC. Here you can see there are different blocks like the IDS reporter, IDS system, security sensor, and also the security memory. So Trend Micro also have the real solution. It's a software-based IDPS solution called Trend Micro IoT Security for Automotive. So TMIS actually is a software-based IDPS system that we recommend it can be deployed in the vehicle critical ECU like the IVI head unit and also the TCU telematic control unit. IVI considers a very complex system with so many interfaces, talks to external and internal interface. So we consider this is a dirty and a critical point, need to be secure. So Trendmicro TMIS will provide the IDS to detect anything abnormal as a sensor and also a security agent to do the real-time protection for this critical ECU. Then in the TCU, the TMIS log reporter can send any necessary log to the vehicle SOC. In the meantime, a CAN bus anomaly detection sensor should be considered deployed in the central gateway, where you can see most of the CAN bus message flying through and detect any abnormal behavior in your car CAN bus. However, we don't recommend to send all those log or event directly to your vehicle SOC because that will cause a lot of trouble for the administrator or analyzer in the vehicle SOC. There are too many events and logs to be watching. So we would suggest to sending those log to the Trendmicro XDR Vision 1. Meanwhile, it will correlate the data from off-board sensor, for example, from your mobile phone, from your IT backend, or even other cloud. So everything put into the data lake of this XDR platform, combined with our strong threat intelligence know-how in the backend, for example, Trendmicro research team, and also the ZDI team, that is the largest bug bounty program company in the world. All in all, the threat intelligence will help you to filter the critical alert to provide the early warning and also prioritize the event that is going to send to your vehicle SOC. By doing this, we will reduce SOC effort. We also found our customer have a big problem is to process the data that coming from the vehicle. So we would like to reduce the data volume from the vehicle. Intelligent sensor in the car, which is not just a simple data collector sending or transfer log to the cloud. Instead, combined with machine learning model or threat expert rule in this intelligent sensor, we are able to filter something we don't want and to just keep something we like to further analyze to your backend SIM platform. By doing this, we save a lot of data volume and also save your cost. The next one, to have the visualization of the whole ecosystem, we have the SIM platform for vehicle SOC. In this vehicle SOC, in this SIM platform, we are able to look into the car location and also where all those attack comes from. In the middle, you will see some critical event that's sending from our XDR platform, which highlight those critical events you need to take care of. Once you click into this smart alert, you can go to Trendmicro Vision 1 platform and continue for the deeper threat analysis and the finding the root cause of the attacks. This was just a simple example that Trendmicro can do. However, we also believe in order to win this battle, we need to work together with our partner, with our customer. Because we understand this case ecosystem is super huge and there is no single company can win the war just by themselves. So we believe to be open and to be better together. One example here is Tesla. We know they have a very good bug bounty program inside the company. However, Trendmicro's ZDI also have the bug bounty program work with them closely to find the potential vulnerability of the car and also help them to provide this fixed solution in very early stage. And also, we will see Trendmicro provide a lot of research white paper here for your reference. And we join different kind of a consortium and we provide our experience for the industry with our partner. By doing this, we believe we can jointly work together and secure the future automotive industry and the ecosystem. Thank you for listening, and I'm happy to listen to your feedback. And if you have anything about automotive cybersecurity, please feel free to contact me to contact Trendmicro. Thank you.